K tutorial number 1, defining lambda, lesson 3. Here we learn how to use the K strict attribute to define desired evaluation strategies. We'll also learn how to tell K which terms are already evaluated, so it does not attempt to evaluate them anymore and treats them internally as results of computations. Recall from the previous lecture that the lambda program free variable capture.lambda was stuck, because K was not given permission to evaluate the arguments of the lambda application construct. You can use the attribute strict to tell K that the corresponding construct has a strict evaluation strategy, that is, that its arguments need to be evaluated before the semantics of the construct applies. The order of argument evaluation is purposely unspecified when using strict. And indeed, the K tool allows us to detect all possible non-deterministic behaviors that result from such intended underspecification of evaluation strategies. We will learn how to do that when we define the IMP language later in this tutorial. We will also learn how to enforce a particular order of evaluation. In order for the above strictness declaration to work effectively and efficiently, we need to tell the K tool which expressions are meant to be results of computations so that it will not attempt to evaluate them anymore. One way to do it is to make val a syntactic subcategory of the built-in kResult syntactic category. Compile again and then run some programs. They should all work as expected. In particular, free variable capture.lambda now evaluates to A, Y. We now got a complete and working semantic definition of call by value lambda calculus. While theoretically correct, our definition is not easy to use and disseminate. In the next lessons, we will learn how to generate formatted documentation for lambda and how to extend lambda in order to write human-readable and interesting programs.